What up, everybody? Day 198 making song right here. Today I'm working on color blending. Yes. So anyways, yesterday I was working on color schemes. Really settled on a bunch of good colors that I'm happy with. This is one color swatch, essentially. And the thing that we're going to work on now is blending colors together. As you see, I've kind of got two different areas here. And as I go from one area to the other, you can see the water right here is nice and it's greenish color because we're in this sort of like this darker area. But it needs to be able to blend those two waters together. So I'm gonna actually take the color of each area and the areas around it and blend the colors together. And that should make it so it looks a lot better as we do this transition here. That's the first goal for today. So, starting off with that. Yesterday I finished all the color swatches too to make it just really organized. So I actually have all my color swatches in a single file. I only have one color swatch so far for the overworld, but. If I were to add another one, I could totally do that. So, and then it'll randomly choose amongst the color swatches that it knows works to choose a color scheme for the current world based on its world seed. So, yeah, I'm going to have to make a function that blends. It's going to be one, two, three, four, five. Yeah, there's six different colors that has to blend together to create the right color for water. And I'm going to start by doing this straight up in the water tile function, and then I'll eventually turn this into a separate function. So we'll do color 3B color. This is what we're going to end up using here instead of K colors, or instead of the water color. What's up, Canada? Yeah, I'm online. I'm streaming. What's up, Lime Studios? Looks like the stream's going all right. All right. Okay, so yeah, you guys just joined. I was talking about what I'm gonna do today. I'll give you a little visual of what the goal for today. I'm actually blending colors together. So I'm gonna go from this area right here and blend this blue watercolor into this green color. So that transition looks really smooth and nice. All right, Azarus. What's up, Alessandro? Jonah19. Yeah. Momir, what's up? Yeah, I was thinking about you guys today. I actually tried to get started a whole hour earlier than this. But at least it's an hour earlier than usual, so. Yeah, so you guys probably just saw there. I'm blending colors today, so. Okay, so the first thing I need to do is I'm just going to write like some pseudocode of how this is going to work. I want to get the west area's color. Get the west and the east area's colors and blend with this color, then it's going to be the north and south. All right, good, right on. Oh, I know what you mean. I used to have college internet too. I went to college for a whole year and a half, and it was the same thing. Sometimes our internet was rad. We had a good T1, but Man, sometimes it was just all bogged down because everybody's playing Quake and StarCraft. Get the north and south areas colors and blend with this color. And then blend the two colors to create the final result. That's kind of how this is out. This is going to work. What's up, Keenan? Yes, I do all the pixel art and I do all the music too. I write my music in Ableton. I use Photoshop for making the pixel art. And I'm using Xcode here to make all the code. Yeah, I was working on the overworld probably. Now I'm working on actually different color swatches for different types of areas in the game, and I'm blending them together. So here's like one area. This is sort of like a mountain color swatch. And I'm going from mountain area to mountain area. And here I'm going to go to the right and I'm going to go into sort of a darker forest area. And the goal is to now blend this watercolor. This nice blue color, and just blend it into this green. Thanks, man. Okay, so we need to get the west and the east areas colors. Yeah, Quake and StarCraft. We played those. Oh my God. 6 hours a night sometimes. It's like pretty much all my school was. Right on, man. Cool. That's how it is for me too. That's why I'm making this game. This is the ultimate game I've always wanted to make. Sweet, nice. Yeah, that's just a shader. Yeah, I noticed that when I first made that, it really made the game look a lot better, and I also started getting a lot of more people interested in the game as soon as I added some cool shaders. Nice, man. Welcome to the stream. So the west area is color. Yes, it was. Yes, it was. Yes. There's gonna be light in the dark and dark in the light. That's right. The little white dot inside the black, yin and yang. So we need a color 3B, west color, east color. Might as well just get north color, south color. Yeah. And particles. Zeth, what's up, man? Dude, what's up? Oh, how you been? Oh, it's been a long time since I've seen you on here. Zeth. Okay, we can just start with doing. Yeah, exactly. I like how Twitch didn't star you out because you combined those two words. Okay, so once we've got the, let's just get the west color anyways. So west color will be something that, so like if I'm in the current area and it has water on the edge of it, it will have to get the color for the area to the left of it or the west. So for example, if there were water right here on this edge, it would need to go and blend the watercolor. So first it needs to test if there's any water on this edge. But for now, I'm just gonna go blend it anyways. So I'm gonna grab this area's color, that area's color, and then there's gonna be a middle color, which is this area's color, and there's gonna be a third color, which is this area's color. And so we'll blend all those together to create sort of a middle color, and then do the same thing for north south. So north, or north up here, south, whatever. So it's six colors that has to blend all together to create a final color. Hey, what's up, Lighter Thief? Welcome to the stream. So we might as well just go west color equals area pause dot x is greater than zero. Yes, that's gonna be world area area pause dot x minus 1 area pause dot z dot y area pause dot z. Otherwise, it's just this area's colors k color water. Oh, and this is dot get color. What? I should have a get color method. Weird. The black terrain ashes. Let's see. Do you mean on this area over here? This is meant to be not really ashes. It's just meant to be to sort of like a dark, mysterious, creepy forest. And I've got plans to make this even darker. So I'm going to add some darkness underneath these trees and sort of these light beams as well, kind of poking through. Yeah, I'm good, man. Yeah, doing great. Yep. I've been on this crazy cleanse, and I'm finally starting to have good energy again. Yeah, okay, so I don't know. I guess I wasn't really intending for it to be ashes, but because it kind of looks like ashes, right? There's actually a method I have for area. So let's just do that. West area equals this get area. Why is this an int ref? Oh, because it. Oh, what is this? Xcode detour? Or I mean, CocoStudioX? Man, CocoStudioX keeps on creeping up their namespace so much. Yeah, kind of like a bayou or a swamp, yeah. That's kind of what I was thinking for this first one, right? Like I said, there'll be multiple tile sets. So, but I'm thinking this original tile set here will kind of be more like a swamp or more like a, kind of like a graveyard meets a swamp. Well, man, this is just kind of annoying to have to call this method with, like that. So let's make a better one. Oh, let's make I got an idea. We'll go like this. There'll be a const area pointer. Returning null will mean that it is. That area does not exist. No, I guess we could just return the current area. Const area ref get area dir d. Oh, hold on. Gotta get this. Pizza delivery. It's not actually pizza. Yeah, that'll work. Const get area. This is gonna be a better, just a really much easier method to use. Unreal, what's up? Yes, I was invisible there for a second. Actually, I was answering the door. It's an important package arriving today. Area, get area. Okay, so if we gotta grab the area, the size. Yeah, we can just go like this. Pause P, area pause, add dir. If world has pause P, return world area. Otherwise, return this area. So it falls back, can always return a guaranteed area. Cool. So then we can use this method to just really simplify that whole business up there. It's not like in expected. Oh, yeah. So we got the west color. This can totally be simplified now. This get area. Okay, west dot get color. Okay, color water. There we go. Yeah, awesome. So I'm just kind of feeling my way through this algorithm to start with. Kind of started with some pseudo code. Okay, so we're gonna get a color for the horizontal color, basically. So horizontal color equals a mix of the west color and this thing's colors, okay, color, water. I'm working on blending colors. Let me show you. So yesterday I was working on color swatches. I can now change the entire swatch. Like, it's basically, there's multiple types of areas, right? There's mountains, there's light forest, there's dark forest, there's sandy areas. All of them have their own kind of color swatch, and I can swap that out with different types of worlds too. So it's really flexible. But now I'm making it so it blends color. So I watch as I go to this darker area. I got sort of a green watercolor here and this dark sort of meant to look like more like poison or something. And I go back here, it's all blue. So there's not a nice transition. There's a harsh transition from that blue to that green. So I'm just making it so it blends those together. So yeah, I want to mix west. And this area's color. I think by half. Yeah, totally. Very, very, very easy now to have diverse types of land. And let me show you what I mean. I got this all separated out into data structures. So, the first entry is the Z level with, and I got a keyword called overworld, which actually translates to zero. And then I've got different color swatches, right? So if I were to go and create another color swatch, it would just be easy as that. I would go, okay, now I have color swatch number one. And it all the light areas have this, all the dark areas have that mountain. And I could even do things like this. Like there's three levels of each type of area. So if I could go light one equals this, light two equals that, and create some really detailed color swatches. And then when it runs the game, based on your six-letter world code, it chooses a random color swatch. So it would either choose this one or that one. So by the time I'm done with this game, I'll probably have like three or four different color swatches that it'll choose from. I'm thinking because they're actually these take a while to create, but yeah, that'll really add a lot of diversity to the game. Hey yo, what's up, Big Mac Dev? Yo. It's data driven. Exactly. Yeah, Jonah 19. You know what I'm going for? Data driven is awesome. The less code this game has, the better. Right now, it has too much code. I mean, every day I add more code. 32,000, 32,500. Just a week ago, it was only 32,000. It's like every week I write 500 more lines of code. I really need to totally get down on a lot of these files and simplify them, make them more data driven, and I can really reduce that. Oh, that would be sweet. Momir, cool idea. I like that so much. An item, or maybe even a Game Genie code. So when you go to the Game Genie cave, I'm gonna add that to the list. An item that changes your swatch, maybe a code that changes your swatch, something like that. Okay, after we've blended with the west color, we want to go horizontal color equals a mix of the current horizontal color and east color 0.5. I think that's supposed to be two 0.5s. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's the swatch switch. Maybe a helmet that chances you to swatch to gore? What do you mean? What's up, Nano? You mean you want a helmet that gives you more gore? Just blood everywhere? I think this might be on the right track here. Let's see. Or swatch switch watch? Yes, it has to be a watch. It's a watch to switch the swatch. It could even be called the watch switch swatch. Or this, the switch swatch watch. Yeah. This is gonna be really fun, right? Once it's all like data driven like this, it makes it really easy to change all this stuff with the switch of an item. Oh, okay. Cool. Horizontal color, vert color is a combination of south. I'm wondering if this is supposed to be a third right here. But we'll see. I don't know. Oh, you know what? Actually, this is supposed to, I think it's supposed to be a quarter. Or 75%. 75% to there so that it creates a half. So let's do it like this. I have a feeling that's the correct way to do it. The Swiss watch, Swiss watch. Oh man. We could go on. No, I haven't finished the temple entrance yet. But it's there, it's waiting. It's going to be finished at some point. Yeah, I want to have a different, I want to have a cool, really awesome, different entrance for every level. So 9 levels, 9 different entrances. It'll create a lot of cool variety on this, on the overworld. And then also I want to fill the overworld with tons of cool stuff like statues and gnarly huge trees and vines and stuff. So yeah, I think we blend the south color, the north color, now color, the final color equals mix of horizontal color and vert color straight down the middle. And then just, yeah, making sure we use it right there with color. Okay, let's see if this even works. I have no idea if this is anywhere near right with those numbers. These are pretty important, these numbers right here. Waterfalls too, yes. Waterfalls are already a part of the map. I just gotta get them drawn. So these little lighter blue areas right here, these are already reserved for waterfalls. There, there. And I'm even gonna make it so the algorithm will draw an additional waterfalls too. Like maybe this waterfall goes up to the next screen, right? And then on this screen, maybe it's another waterfall that goes up to that screen. Who knows? Maybe it's just a pool right here that empties into a waterfall on this screen. So that'll be a fun thing to randomize too. Okay, let's see if this works. Probably won't. It's like nothing ever really works on the first try. It kind of looks like it is. Is it? It's not blending yet, is it? I can't tell. Maybe all these should be 0.5. Like I originally planned. Yeah, see, I can see it turning into green now. Yeah, and this one's turning into blue. But it's not quite right. There's something. Oh, see, it could be also working with how it has to blend there. So if I turn off the vert color. Yeah, it's definitely doing something, right? It's getting there. So if we just go straight up with the horizontal color, let's see if that looks right. Yeah, see, still I can see this slight gap. I wonder why it's not quite perfect. Once I perfect this technique, though, it'll be cool because I can use this for rocks too. So the rocks, like, oh yeah, so you barely even notice it, but these rocks are sort of a yellowish orangish, and these rocks are sort of purple. So I need to blend those as well. Yo, what's up, Clock? What up, man? What's up, man? Okay, well, we need to get in and check it out. Why are cats such attention seekers? Good question. Sometimes they want attention, and sometimes they just want to run away and hide underneath the bed. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I know exactly why it's not working yet. It's usually when they want food, right? Yeah. Well, independent, smart, quick things. So the reason it's not working yet is because it shouldn't be a straight up blend. It needs to blend based on the X position and the Y position. So, all the way at the bottom, that's when you want a full blend. And then at the top, same thing. So, I got to get percentages here. Okay, so we need the X percentage for this. So we got XP, YP. Okay, so we're gonna need to just set up some variables separate. Color 3B, horizontal color, the vertical color. Now, if the X percentage is less than or now let's do less than 0.5, then the horizontal color is a mix of the west color and this color. Based on so I want if XP is 0, it'll be entirely the west color. So it's just XP times 2. So if XP is about 0.5, that'll give us a 1.0 value, which would be fully this thing's color. I'm pretty sure that will create the wrong result anyways, but let's start with that. I think this needs to actually be a minimum of, instead of 0 to 1, this thing should be more like 0.5 to 1. Let's just do that. Let's start with my instinct. I'm pretty sure that should be XP plus 0.5. So if XP is 0, this will give us 0.5, which will mean that it's halfway from the area to the left's color to this color. Yeah, because I want it at the edge, it needs to be a halfway blend. That'll create a nice smooth transition. Okay, pretty sure that's right. And then the other way, the other side is going to be a blend of this color and east color of just XP. So at 0.5, no, I want XP minus 0.5. So at when XP is 0.5, it's going to be, this is going to come back to be 0, so it'll be entirely this area's color. When this is, actually, I can shorten this too. Might as well be explicit here. And then, yeah, so if XP is all the way to 1, we're gonna get 0.5, which will do halfway to the east color. Okay, let's see how this turns out. Let's see if we can go from this area to that area, and it looks like a really nice smooth transition. Okay, this is good because I'm seeing some blue here, right? And then over here, I'm starting to see it turn into green. Yeah, it worked. Awesome. There you go. So there's a perfect transition right there. Now let's add in the north, south. Yo, what's up, excellence? Yeah, early stream today. I'm trying to stream earlier for people in Europe. So many European watchers. Yeah, totally. This is cause for celebration already. I can't believe this works already. So we want, okay, now we want the vert color equals blah, blah, blah. I should just stream 24/7. Like 12 of those hours a day would be nothing. I'd be invisible. It's not nothing. It's just that it's just that I'm invisible. South color, north color, right? YP, vert color, south, YP. Bird color, north. Okay, let's see how this blends with all six areas being blended together. Oh, it broke this one. Damn. Why is that? Yes, ninjas. So if we went entirely with the horizontal color again. Yeah, well, five. Okay, just five, sorry. Yeah, there's east, west, north, south, and the current area. It's blending all those together. Okay, good. We've got the horizontal. That looks good. That's a perfect blend. But as if you go to the south, yeah, it's messed up. Right on. Cool, man. Yeah, I'm glad Valtry is helpful. So if we went entirely with the vertical color, hopefully that'll make it so this vertical transition is perfect. And then I'll just have to figure out why. Yeah, okay, so this transition is now wrong. But this one does seem to be right. Okay. Tappy, what's up, man? How you doing? I'm working on some color blends here, blending this watercolor between five areas. Let's make sure we got all these variables right. YP is Y over height. YP is less. We're gonna mix the vert color equals the south color with this color. YP plus five. So if we're all the way at the bottom row, zero, that would create 0.5, which would mean it's pretty much halfway to this color. And then vert color greater than 0.5 is going to be starting at 0.5, so this becomes zero, mostly this, and goes to a maximum of 0.5, which would be halfway to the north. This is north, south, east, west. All looks okay. Dang. Yeah, things are going good. That's a good question, right, Asmerus? I was just checking that to see if north and south are flipped. Maybe. I mean, let's check this out. This should be all correct. How much do I have left? About 4 months until it's released, and then a whole year after that of making it better and porting it to more platforms. So, in total, probably another year and a half. Okay, so I'm just going back in and running the code once more to see. It would be really nice to have an area where I could see a blend of all the colors. So, yeah, once again, we've got this transition not quite working again. I bet this has to do with, like it should probably blend. Okay, yeah, I'll check it. What's up, Arcane? No, 0, 0 is the bottom left. Thanks, man. Yeah, okay, I'll check it. Let's go right before it's setting the north color. We'll see what area it's getting there. So P is the current area pause, which is 6.5. It's adding the direction north. So it should end up with 6.6. And it does. Okay, so yeah, that's correct. We'll check the south one as well. Starting off with a 0.65 again, and this should be turned 6.4. Yeah, 6.4. Okay, yeah, that's fine. I think it has to do with. I wanna run around in God mode because I feel like I'm almost understanding what's going on. Maybe there's a better area which can kind of easily be an easier way to illustrate. Man, that transition's too quick to be able to see it. Here's a green area. Yeah, actually, that area I was on was actually a really good area to test. Well, sorry if that was loud. That's a good area too. See, here's a nice area to blend north south. Let's start here. Yeah, right. Yeah, I know. There's individual. There's God mode and invincible. Just put these right next to each other. They're so complementary. But yeah, if I were to turn on invincible, then I would die. God mode just means you can run through walls and run super fast. Right. Okay. So let's turn off God mode now. Now that we're on this area. Nice, cool. I'm glad it's looking living. That's really the point. Should look really alive. Yeah, see, we're not getting that blend there. Okay, well, I guess the next thing we should do is blend. Oh, see, this is a perfect example right here. This area is really, really important to blend correctly because we've got a west-east edge. Oh, but that's the same color. We just really have a north-south edge. Actually, yeah, I could make this algorithm work better in most cases by checking the edges. So it's just there. I know there's going to be a problem when there's so many edges that blend together. So what I'm saying here is, this area only needs to blend with the south. Even though it has water over here, this does not need to be blended because this area has the same color as this area. So this green and that green don't need to be blended. But down here, it needs a blend of blue. Heart of Darkness? What's that one? Oh, cool. Pixel art. Huh. I never played this one. This looks rad, though. Cool. Tryhard Monkey. Does anyone know of a good free ways to learn how to code and such for Unity? Yeah, tutorials, man. Not Unity tutorials, just like people's tutorials, like go on YouTube. Don't know, maybe people got better advice on that, 'cause I don't know C sharp and I've only used Unity briefly. Yeah, I know there's some problems, right? The lily pads clip. There's still definitely a lot of other blending issues just besides this water. But thanks for noticing that. Thanks, Connor Groove. Yeah, it's getting better every day. There's a lot more to create. Nice, there you go. Experiment. And I came across, everybody asks me just about every day, how do you start out in game development? And I found probably the best advice I can give is just to watch these tutorials from Extra Credits. But this is a great Extra Credits game design playlist. Maybe you find some advice in here too. Like it starts off at the very beginning, like fail faster, don't waste time. You know, these kind of little things, maybe these will help you. These are not really Unity specific, but I think this helps when you're starting out. Oh, okay, cool. The swamps, nice. Yeah. Hey, what's up, Starloid? Welcome to the stream, man. Okay, so what's let me just think about this for a second. So we got let's go back to that other area. Okay, here we are at this one. Let me just think about this for a second and try and figure out, because if I could get this algorithm to work with all five areas, then it would be way easier than trying to do all this special casing to try and figure out if it should blend or not or whatever. So I need to turn off God mode now. Yeah, you're welcome, man. What library am I using? It's called Cocos 2DX. It's C++, cross-platform, open source. Highly recommend it if you know C++ already. I love it, personally. But that's mostly because I'm very familiar with it. If I wasn't familiar with this engine, I would have no ties to it, and I would probably, explore some other stuff. Okay, so this area, the water is blue. To the left, the water is still blue. To the north, the water would still be blue if there were water. To the south, the water is also blue, but that's not necessarily true because if Because these two areas, it's just lucky that these two areas have the same colored water. But to the east, the water is green. So at this pixel, at this position on the screen, right about here, it's blending. The horizontal color should be blended halfway from blue to green. And then it mixes with the vertical color, which is going to be blended to the south. South is blue. So at the very bottom, it would be halfway between halfway to green. See what I'm saying? Somewhere in there, the math is just off a little bit. Almost had it there. Right? Having to blend the areas diagonally? Is that true? Would you have to? I don't think you would. But I think I see what you're saying. Like maybe on the single area you're on, maybe that needs to be blended diagonally. Let's take a screenshot and I'm gonna visually draw what I'm thinking. Okay, so on this screen, that's going to be blue. That's blue. The current area is blue. The area to the south is even blue. It's just this area to the right, which is green. So it would be that color. But First of all, yeah, I'm just gonna set a breakpoint for this. Set a breakpoint. I know I can figure this out. If so, X is width minus 1 and Y equals height shifted down 1 minus 1. There. I want to set a breakpoint here and then step through these and see what we get for a horizontal and a vertical color. Pixel in the right bottom. Yeah, right. Okay, so this is a good, thank you for helping me trying to think through this. Would be 50% your own screen. Yeah, it should be. Yeah, I think this is theoretically correct. But I'm not sure if this is actually producing that. I don't know. It might be you need to do 9 areas. Arcane, yeah, it's only one resolution. Yeah, but it scales up and down. So it's a widescreen resolution. So it's meant for today's widescreen TVs, widescreen laptops, widescreen phones, all that kind of stuff. Because most screens these days are widescreen. So most screens it'll fit really nicely, but with maybe just a tiny bit of blackness. And then on the iPad is the one screen which is way different than almost everything else. It's like an old school monitor. And that one, there'll be big black bars. And I'm thinking I might actually do some stuff on the edges. Like maybe that will be where the controls are or whatever on the iPad. So really, it's just pretty much the iPad and anything with a ratio like the iPad is going to be kind of an odd device to run this game on. But I'll find some way to make it look good. Yeah, it's 4:3, which is only 1.3333, right? And then most screens these days are 16 by 9-ish, which is 1.77777. It's 640 by 320. See, that's 2 to 1. That's a little too big. Okay, so let's run this and I want to actually see these colors. So I'm going to take what these colors are and put them into Photoshop. Oh, why didn't it stop? Maybe this needs to be minus 2. There, okay, minus 3. So north and south should be the same as, yes, the west color. Oh, it's close. Yeah. Okay, so the south color is a little different actually. So XP, YP, we got XP of 1, YP of 0.36. So yeah, that should be 50%. Towards the east color. So let's see what it turns out to be. 8B, E3, E0. So this is what the horizontal color is turning out to be. Yeah, good. That's a nice blend between this blue and that green. That's what I expected. Good. I'm working on color blending today, actually. What's up, B-Woogie? Welcome to the stream. Okay, now we got YP is going to be less. This is where it's all going to get messed up, I'm sure. So the vert color is a blend of the south color, which is a little different than this area's color. Right? South color, AB. D6. It's just a little more green. But different than the East color, which is APFF. Dodge Whale, what's up, man? The game's gonna cost about 16 bucks, maybe. Maybe 20 bucks, I'm not sure. And it'll be on Steam sometime between January and March. Okay, let's see what happens. Yeah, we got a vert color of 8BC8FF. Which is really blue. That. Yeah, okay. You guys are right. You guys are right. I'm pretty sure what needs to happen is it needs to be blended 9 areas. Because this is what's going to happen. It's going to blend these two areas together and grab more of a greenish color. Think. Let's see what happens when it finally does all this. Okay, so the color result should be about what we see on the screen anyways. 8BD5EF. Yeah, it's almost exactly that same color. Okay. Well, that explains that, but it, yeah, okay, it does have to be 9 areas so that the screen to the right recognizes the screen that's below. Yeah, you're right, Azenris. And Momir, you're basically what you're saying about blending area the areas diagonally, same thing. You guys are both right. So yeah, I basically just have to incorporate the colors for all 9 areas around it, and then we'll have a nice blend. Okay, so I had to do all this visual stuff to figure that out and admit that you guys were right. No, it's not that I didn't want to admit it. It's just that I thought that it was okay to blend just these 5. But anyways, it wasn't, so it's definitely not. And yeah, I'm going to take a quick little break. I'll be right back, and we'll continue blending these colors. Oh, no, man, don't feel dumb. The thing is, you're absorbing this information, and at first you may not understand. You may not be able to even comprehend what's going on. Maybe you do comprehend, but you're not able to help. And but you go through these phases, right? Eventually you will be able to understand and you will be able to help if you want. And the thing is, you don't have to know what's going on to absorb what's going on. And that's kind of how I learned to make art. I just absorbed a ton of it until finally I started doing it. And I'm like, you know what? This is really easy because I've been watching other artists for so long. So this is experience. That's what I'm saying. Okay, we need to blend 9 areas of color. So I'm thinking the best thing to do here now is to switch this all up into just an array of colors. Yeah, well, I mean, you can always go back and watch the YouTube videos from day one, but even then, it'll be mostly absorbing for you. So, but I do recommend it. If you have time, the first videos are a lot different. They really cover the more of the basics. Oh yeah, I guess you just get used to it. Yeah. And I wear comfortable shoes and I have a certain stance where I kind of put my feet together and that enables me to kind of stand for longer. So I need an array of all the other 8 directions of color. Let's call that D colors. Okay, num compass. Thought it was K num compassers. Yeah, I know what you mean. Yep. Oh, did you mean binge? There you go. Become a wizard. Get your gold star. It is. It's K num compassers. Why wasn't that not working? Stupid. Auto complete. Okay. For each compass, there D. D colors. D equals. Oh, now we need to know. We need to change this up. Yes, you do. You get gold stars for watching. Oh. Well, I was confused. I'm not sure whether you're talking about binge or being the Microsoft Google search engine. But I think you were saying binge watch it. But I don't know. Right? Why the heck does Bing even have a user base? Why do people, I guess because it's a default on Windows or something? All right, this get area function needs to be more flexible now to come to do 8 different compass directions. So we're gonna make this a compister. And I think kit's gonna need an add compister function. Ah, binge watching, right. Yes, we need the stars command. Oh. What's up, PMC? Yeah, there you go. Bam. Ah, yeah. Those poor souls. So yeah, we need a method like this, add compistir, start compiling. Hey, what's up? Sean is crazy. Oh. Their south is y minus minus. Their west. Their north. Their east. Southwest is y minus minus and x minus minus. Northwest is y plus plus, x minus minus. Northeast is y plus plus, x plus plus. Southeast, y plus, y minus minus, x plus plus. There. Oh no! Rule Spy, what's up, man? It's going great. I'm working on color blending today. I'll show you what I mean. I'm working on blending too. So there's all these different color swatches, right? We're inside an area right now, which is using a color swatch is like the mountains. So this is kind of how the mountains will look in most areas. There'll be more rocks and stuff in the mountains, and it's not all perfect yet, but. Watch as I go from this area to the next area. The water doesn't blend very well. So I'm working on blending all the colors for water for nine different areas together to create a smooth water transition. And this technique will also be used for blending together rocks. You can see that even the rocks, as I go from here to here, the rocks are like orangish, yellowish sort of. And then over here, they're purplish and there's no smooth blend. So they'll be blended as well. Oh. Oh no. There. Cool. We've upgraded that method. Oh, harsh, man. Harsh. Okay, there, we've got all the colors for all the areas around it. Yeah, right, yeah. Yay, congratulations to everybody who follows and to Songbringer for having over 1,000 followers on Twitch. 24 hours drunk stream. Do we even have any alcohol? Hold on. Let me go see if I can find some alcohol and I will start drinking right now in celebration. Who will be the 1,007th? Am I always drunk? I wish, well, you know what? I actually used to code drunk back in my 20s, but I don't do that anymore. It doesn't really work that good. Yeah, thanks guys. What's up, Amarin? Yeah, let me go see if I got anything. Maybe some wine or something? Some tequila? So Maker's Mark and orange juice is a drink, right? Pretty sure it is. I love XKCD. Programming skill, blood alcohol concentration. This is so true, right? Right about here, you hit this super peak. You're like, yeah! Apple uses automated schnapps called it the Ballmer peak. It was discovered by Microsoft. Remember Windows me? My God, Windows me. Oh. Yeah, totally, right? I know it's. No, that's not a suspicious link, man. That's awesome. XKCD is rad. Maker's Mark and orange juice. It's not really the perfect drink. I wouldn't say it's like I love this drink at all. But you know. Okay, so we gotta get blending these colors. Nine areas. We wanna okay, when we're on a horizontal, let's start figuring this out. I wanna go to this one first. Okay, so the west color is now D colors. Kader West. And pretty much all these are Kader something. East. South. North. Okay, so if we run it now, we should have the same thing we used to have where it's not quite blending it right. So we got to figure out next how to blend in those diagonal edges as well as the horizontal, or as the, as where is the not diagonal. And seeing it run is a good thing. As always, making sure all the code's still compiling. Which is very important while you're drinking. Okay, good. Yeah, we got the same result we used to have. Okay, now when we're going from the west to the east, it's a mix of. Hey, what's up, Lith? What's up, man? Howdy, howdy, howdy. Welcome to the stream. I'm blending colors right now so that the water will look perfectly smooth as it transitions from between two totally different area colored waters. Didn't have a beard? No way. I've always had a beard. Oh, you're right. I was shaved when I first started this game. I forgot about that. Yeah, even probably the first video of making Songbringer, I was still shaved. This is like the first time I ever streamed right here. That's going good, dude. Really good. Yep, we're celebrating over 1,000 subscribers. Well, not subscribers. What do you call them on Twitch? Followers? 1,000 followers on Twitch, and I'm celebrating with Maker's Mark and orange juice. Not exactly a good drink, but you gotta celebrate. Gotta celebrate. It's very important in life. All work, no play makes Jack a dull boy. Followers, right? Yeah. Thank you, man. Thank you. It's getting close on Twitch, or I mean on Twitter too. Where are we at on Twitter? And this is all since starting this game, see, right? When I started this game, I had zero followers anywhere. None on Twitter, none on Twitch, nothing. So, yeah, 889 followers on Twitter as well. Pretty bomb. Yes, he did, right? Oh, yeah, that's right. He had that afro. Oh, it's true. Forgot about that. He looked like a stormtrooper for a minute, too. Oh, thank you, Azenris. That's what I was just about to start thinking about. Bottom right, 25% current. 25% south, 25% east, 25% southeast. I think so. I think I'm going to blend it with the first two right here. So we're going to start with. So we're going to have to do a mix of the east and the southeast if we're in. I got it. So right here, it's a mix of if YP is less than 0.5, it's a mix of D colors, Dir East, and Dir South, or I mean Dir Southeast. And split that half. Well, no, we have to split that by Y. Yes, totally. So funny. It's how far this game's come, right? That's what I'm saying. When you just work on something for a long, long time, you get so much better. I'm pretty sure this would be YP minus 0.5. Is getting to be really long though. Right? This needs to be somehow simplified into better. This is what happens when you code and drink at the same time. Mix D colors. Dir East with Northeast. Oh no, this one. Oh yeah, the south one is plus 0.5. And then the north one is gonna have to swap east. And northeast. And subtract 0.5. Try following that in the debugger. You know what? This should really do, I should be. I'm gonna write this into a separate function, a tiny little lambda function, which blends three colors. That'll really, really help this whole thing. Write-only code. It's walk. Yeah, I think a lambda function would really help out here. Oh, now that's simpler. That's a simpler way to think of it, actually. Let's think about that. Now, I'm not sure if that would work because then you're not taking into account the diagonal. So, like for example, if we just separate this out to be just this area right here. Just this bottom quadrant, this bottom right, then it would only be mixing this area's color with this area's color and that area's color and that area's color. It's almost the same thing as the algorithm I just had before, But what I really want to do here is combine in the diagonal, and that gets combined into the south and the north. So I think it does require one more step than that. I hope. We'll see. You might be right. You might be right. So let's make a little lambda function, which is really nice and smart. It can blend two colors. Three colors, I mean. We don't need the decolors, we need the color one. Color three. And this is the percentage. Oh. Now I see what you're saying. Okay, let's think about So the current color mixed with that color, and that color. Oh, maybe you're right. Okay, let's try that first, because that does sound a lot more simple. And in fact, all I got to do is just do a lambda of with four colors. Let's make this a little shorter. Now I don't even need a lambda, actually. Okay, yeah. I like this whole method. This is cool. All we need are four directions then. We need the four directions that we want to mix, and then just mix all four of those colors, 25% each. So we just have to determine based on. Based on the X and Y, we get a quadrant. Actually, I think I have a function called compass direction from vector. So if I go compass direction from vector and I give it a vec2 of xp minus 0.5 times 2. And same thing with y. That'll give y and x 1 to 0, or I mean negative 1 to 1. And I don't think I need to pass in flags, is that correct? Just have a default. Oh, I guess I gotta pass in flags. Oh, I need k input allow all. All right, Jonah, good night, man. So that'll give us a quadrant. And then I can switch the quadrant. Oh man, actually this is gonna do, shoot. Oh yeah, okay, that's not gonna quite work. Dope. Okay, let's just switch, nah, we gotta do, I don't know, if XP is less than 0.5, and YP is less than 0.5, we need to get all the directions, so we need compass, ders, 4. So this is a blend of, well, the first direction. Okay, we need 9 actual compass directions. So not the 9th compass direction. Is the current. Probably not going to need this horizontal color, vert color either. Okay, so the directions, if we're in the lower left, are k num compassers. South, southwest, west. Oh, you don't like that, huh? Maybe if I make this a vector, it'll work. Yeah, it likes that. Yay! Okay, I mean, this isn't maybe the smartest way to do it, but at least it's readable. This is kind of like I can look at this code and go, oh, okay, I get it. Let's make this even smarter. So now I'm not duplicating, I'm not coupling the fact of less than and greater than or equals to. So YP is less than 0.5, we got this southwest corner. Otherwise, we've got XP still less than 0.5, we're in the northwest corner. That's this direction, west, northwest, and north. This is south and east, so we got this one. Doesn't really matter. South, southeast, and east. And then this one is gonna be northeast, so we got north, northeast, and east. Okay, now we just loop over the directions and mix all the colors. So the current color. So the current color is the first color, and then we're going to mix, we're going to go for all the other directions. Color equals mix. color with this next color. Okay, well, I guess that would do it if it works. Let's see. hope no. Is anybody sees any bugs in what I just wrote? Please let me know. I don't feel drunk or anything, but I might be. Oh, didn't work at all. It's so weird. The areas around it are getting the green color. So this color should be green here. And this color should be blue. Oh, weird. This one, the edges are all messed up. Okay, well, I'm gonna start by stepping. Let's try and figure out what's going wrong. All right, this is X16, Y7. That is really close to the right edge and almost halfway up the screen. Yeah. Yeah, the two are identical on purpose. So this is dividing the X, and then each X you need to divide the Y. So that's why they're exactly the same. You just gotta hit that sweet spot, man. I know, I'm looking for that huge peak, but it's not coming yet. Hopefully you guys witness it. Because I don't know what I'll be thinking when it happens. So, XPYP, what does that come out to be? 0.8, 0.36. That's about right. You think a loop is wrong? Yeah, that's probably one of the most important parts here is this loop, right? Right, so it starts off at 50%, the first one is 50%, so it would be 50% the original and 50% the next color, right? And then you blend it again at 50%, and then it becomes thirds and then quarters, right? Yeah, I think it is doing that already, though. I think it is doing 50% each time. So this is the southeast corner. We've got DIRS, KNUM, compass DIRS. Well, first of all, let's see if all the D colors are correct. So this should be this area. ABC7FF, that should match that. ABC7, yeah. That's correct. And we're going to be dealing with Yeah. Right, so if I were to fix that, I would do I did 0.25 each time. No, the first one should be 0.25. The next one should be. Oh, you know what? I could do a mix of. I could do it this way. I could just separate it into halves. That's probably be easier than having to do it this other way. So we'll do C1 equals a mix of the first color and the next color halfway. Yeah, screw this loop. And then the next one is a mix of the other two colors. And then the final color result is a mix of C1, C2, 0.5. It's more readable anyways. Come on, come on. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Perfect blend. Oh. Thanks, Somomir and Azenris. Good job, guys. I don't know what's going on here. I don't know why the center of that is different than the edge. Something's wrong with the tile, I think, there. In fact, I just need to check it out. Yeah! Thank you, guys. Thank you for all of your suggestions and helps along the way. This is really, thanks to you guys that it's working right now. So, I think I'm gonna check out these tiles for, because I'm like kind of bugged by that whole issue when you walk straight south now. Why the heck those? No, Dodge Whale is not saying the same color. I'll run into God mode and I'll show you what I mean. It's meant to, it looks like it's the same color, but it's because it's really blending a lot of colors together. But it is changing. It's slowly shifting. If I were to have more and more of these green areas, you would see it totally get to be green. And in fact, when I get into GOG mode, you'll be able to see that as I run to an area which is mostly is just all green and everything around it is green. So I think there might be something up with these water tiles. I just checked these in. All right, messed with them a second ago. That's gray, 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 gray. I guess it's not that. Don't It's really weird. Okay, wait. If I never even do any of this, does it have this color blending issue? Oh, see? There's no color blending issue here. Huh, I wonder what's going on with that. It works perfectly except for the edges of the water. Don't know what's going on there right now. But I'll figure it out at some point today. Let's get into God mode and we'll run around and see how it's blending across the whole world. Oh man, see, there's definitely an issue there. Okay, I wonder what's. Oh, okay. So, okay, the current area, right? It can't just be a blend of everything around it. It also has to be a blend of the other areas on this screen. So it is an eight compasser. You know what I mean? It needs eight directions, not just four. Right? Is that correct? That one area over there really, really illustrated the point of that. See, and that totally explains why this area right here is switching, because that's right where the transition is, right there from 0.5 to the next one. This area right here really illustrates it. This one's coming out green because this area is green, this area is green, this area is green, and this area is green. No, this area is not green. Yeah, that area is blue. So this area is mostly green. One, two, three out of four areas of green. That's why this quadrant here is green. And then this one is blue because that's blue, that's blue, that's blue, and this one's green. Okay, no worries though. We just gotta figure out what's the right blend now. What's up, Vlad? Ahoy! Ahoy! Arg! Yeah. You call it a feature. As always, we could call it a feature. Yeah, so I guess you're right. You would have to take all, you would take this method, do it four times, blend all those equally, and you would get the right color for the whole map. Well, no, just for that. Oh man, I'm getting confused now. Definitely haven't hit the sweet spot yet. Not sure I will either, because this is definitely a very cerebral activity with a very anti-cerebral drink. Vlad, we're trying to mix colors, man. And I'm also celebrating the fact that Songbringer has 1,000 viewers or 1,000 followers. It's true, Vlad, you're still fresh. Vlad, here's the problem, man. It blends together. Oh, whoops. Okay, the point is to blend together colors, right? Because this area right here is green, but the area around it right here is bluish water, right? So this one has bluish water, this one has greenish water. So we've got an algorithm in place now that blends together based on a quadrant you're in. So this quadrant down here blends together this green color with that green color and that green color and this blue color to get a mostly green color. But this color here is blue, which blends with blue. Well, this color here is actually starts with green, blends with blue, blue, and blue to create sort of a this sort of greenish blue color here. And this one's even more blue. So you get the point, right? So now we need to find a way to mix together the four quadrants as well. Nice, 1,009. Whoa. Yeah, totally, right? Yeah. You have to blend in all four. Or I wonder if you were to count. What about this? What if I went a quarter on this? Man, I hope this works. Tiger Tooth. How did I learn C++? I learned from books, man. But that was 20 years ago before we had YouTube and Code Academy and all the other awesome things that you got today. Oh, yeah, that didn't work at all. Okay. Man, I was hoping that would work. Okay, maybe not. Okay, so but if we were to blend all four quadrants. What if this were 1, 2, 5? Yeah, that's what I'm trying to do. That's what I'm trying to, that's what this is XP and YP is based on. Oh, wait, no, you're right. You're totally right. This doesn't even take into account XP and YP when it blends these colors. Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, that's what needs to happen. These need to be based on XP and YP, not just 0.25, 0.25, 0.25. Definitely not. Oh, yeah, that'll totally work. Okay, so I only need four areas of color per quadrant, but they need to be blended correctly, like a gradient, just like Vlad said. Yes, ex or like Xpixel is trying to say too. Same thing. It's just XP. This needs to be. This one needs to be based on. Well, one of these needs to be based on XP. One of these needs to be based on YP. What's up, BenoaNet? Welcome to the stream, man. Okay, so I can put these compass directions so they blend horizontal and vertical. Yeah, okay, I got this. I got this. I think I'm in the sweet spot. So when we set the DIRS, we also need to set an XP and a YP. So I can't have janky code here. We need DIRS, we need XP, we need YP. Oh man. Cross compile. Oh no. Yeah, Android linking can be so crazy. Oh no, man. Oh good. Yeah, I'll try and forget about that day behind you. Look forward to the day ahead. It does exist. All right, Sage. You leveled up. So in this corner, so this is just gonna be all based on XP now. This one's gonna be based on YP. And then they'll be blending together half. And so these need to be, make sure these are horizontal. So this is the lower left or the southwest quadrant. So we need to blend this first with west. And then south and southwest can be blended. And then, this one's already correct. West, northwest. Well, actually, I'm gonna put northwest last. So it's always mixing the diagonal one last. And then this one is, we need east first. And this one also east first. Yeah, like that. And then these need to set their XP and their YP. Oh, nice, yeah. Yeah, in C it used to be necessary. I'm not sure it's even necessary anymore in C++. Oh, nice, Speedy Flip, cool. Wow, I think that's a record. 52 viewers. At least it's the first time I've heard of it. Okay, so when we're in the X is to the left thing. Yeah. X is to the left, then X is XP minus 0.5 times 2. Wait, no, that's not right. It's just XP times 2. This one is XP on the right, so it's XP minus 0.5. Times 2. And then YP this is YP less than 0.5, so it's just YP times equals 2.0. So this is let me think through this. XP is say 0, XP times 0 is of course. All right, but XP is say 0.25. That's going to become 0.5. 0.5 is going to become 1. So yeah, that's correct for XP. This one, XP is say 0.5. That's going to be minus 0.5 is 0. 0.75, that's going to be 0.25 times, yeah, it's 0.5. So, and then 1. 1 minus 0.5 is 0.5 times 2 is 1. Yeah, that's all good. Same thing here. And this is similar to this algorithm here Y for YP. So YP is YP minus 0.5 times 2. And this is going to be the same thing down here and here. Let's see if it works. I'm running it before I even think anymore. Nice. Programming until soccer. Yeah, that worked. Oh, this one didn't work. Damn. Damn, damn, damn. What did I do wrong? Oh, it totally is. Yeah, Android. Oh, I know what you mean, man. I have this project called Rapid Game, and that's what I use to pre-compile CocoStudiX. Rapid Game is such a bitch to upgrade because they change stuff and Android compiling, and oh, it's like I have to get CocoStudiX to work and compile all of it into a nice library on Windows, Mac, Linux, Android, iOS, everything. So every time I upgrade it, it's like a whole day. Okay, well, let's set some breakpoints and figure out what's up. What's up with this? Still vote for all four corners done, and then mix those based on your X and Y. Well, current screen. Just gonna try it. Instead of thinking through it too much, I'm just gonna try it. Yeah. My head hurts too. No, actually, my head doesn't yet. That's good. Maybe I do have the sweet spot. Okay, I'm just gonna go ahead and copy and paste this code into a backup. Then I'm just gonna undo what I just did. And then I'm going to create a method for blending them all together. So create a little lambda function. Okay, quad color. Ah. What's up, Code Sparrow? Yo, man. It's been a while since I've seen you. Hope you've been good. So we'll start with K Southeast. We need some durs. Nice, right on, man. You passed all your exams. Woo! And you're starting a C sharp course? Cool. Good language. So this function will just blend four quadrants. Well, four, not blend for a quadrant. Right? I think that's about right. And then we'll mix all those. Oh, right on, man. Yeah, that's rad. Wow. Woo. Nice, man. What language will you be coding in on the server side? Okay, so we want to get every quad color and then mix the XP, YP, and all that. So C1 is a mix of get quad color. Oh, wait. No, we want. I think we might need to do four colors here, actually. Yeah, four colors, right? Nice, man. Sounds like you got this organized. No way. Oh, okay. So C1 is going to be horizontal or west. Let's make this readable. West color is get quadrant color. Okay, southwest mixed with get quadrant color. Okay, northwest based on YP. So if YP is 0, it's going to be entirely the southwest. YP is 1, it's going to be entirely the northwest. East color. Yeah, totally. Yeah. Drink water. Nice. I'll try that next time. Okay, and then the east color is just southeast mixed with northeast based on YP. And then we mix them all together based on the YP. Bam! Once again, I'm running it before I even check it. Unused variable XP. Oh, whoops. Okay, hold on. There was a bug. This is supposed to be XP. There. Okay, running it before I even check it. Because I'm in the zone, man. Come on, work, work. Ooh, looks like that transition is okay. Oh, this is a good sign. There's no more of this weirdness here. Oh, it worked. It worked. Oh, sick. Check this out. Oh, yeah. Oh, nice. Thanks, Azenris. Azenris, coming together with the algorithm. You're like the quarterback of this algorithm, man. Bam! Oh, that's sweet. Yeah, the bridge is weird because I haven't done this algorithm for. There's water tiles and then there's a separate bridge tile. So I just have to do the bridge tile version too. Yeah, man, this took the whole stream just to get this one little algorithm done. 2 hours and 15 minutes, man, I gotta get going. Yeah, but anyway, so now what I got to do is take this and turn it into an algorithm or just a function that I can call from anywhere. So this whole madness right here needs to be a flexible function that I can call from creating a water tile, creating a bridge tile. Also, I'm going to use this for rock tiles as well. So rock tiles will be blended as well. But let's turn off God mode and run around a little bit more so we can kind of see it at the regular pace. Yeah. Right? Let's do this little transition here. Yay. Oh, yeah, that was a good use of fire right there. Wow, fire. I just noticed the fire sword is really good in small corridors. All right, yeah. So, sorry that I got to get going now, but man, this is looking good. So, I got to apply this same technique to these bridge tiles, and then I got to also apply it to rock tiles, and this is going to look sweet. Perfect blending. So it blends so nicely from green to blue or whatever, if it were yellow. In fact, let's do that. Let's do some weird yellow colors just to illustrate this fact. Yeah, so I'll just change the color from of say the dark areas water. I'll change it to just like piss yellow. And you get the point. Now you want a new beta. It's coming soon. So this one, it is blending to yellow, but it's not blending that much because there's really not that much. There was only one area versus four other ones that were blue. That's why it didn't really shift much to yellow there. But down here, yeah, so you can see now this water is looking a lot more like piss. And then it looks even more like piss right here. Actually, that yellow color is kind of cool. It really works well for this dark area. All right, yeah, so that's it. Once again, thanks for sticking with me for today's stream. Thanks for all your help, Azenris, Momir, Vlad. You guys really help with the algorithm there. Appreciate it. So, yeah, I'll be back again tomorrow, same wizard time, usually 2 to 4 p.m. Pacific time. If anybody's just joining this stream, the game you're seeing here is called Songbringer. It's coming out in about 4 months on Steam. So, yeah. All right, that's it. See you guys later.